Welcome to the 2015 African Fashion Week Nigeria, happening live Echo Hotel and Suite. Hey, Adetokunba Ademola, Victoria Island, Lagos State, Nigeria is the place to be. And my people, today we are bringing it because we're not ready to settle for second place. I need not talk too much tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, as I always say this, fashion is in the clothes, style is in the wearer. Everyone can buy fashion, but style you have to own. Fashion unites us, but style sets us apart. Yes, and don't wonder what I have on. This is my twilight mode. I am looking at everyone in 3D. Woohoo! Mwah! That's my friend over there. All right, so it's the red carpet and we're getting everyone, trust me, to harass everybody today. And I'll be bringing that to you live. AFWN African Fashion Week Nigeria 2015. And then, of course, it's the official countdown to African Fashion Week London 2015. 7th and 8th of August 2015 at that. But that's in London. Now, Nigeria, we're doing now. Oh, yeah, now. Forget first scarcity, forget say diesel no deal, forget say kerosene says scarce. We're making it happen today. Are you ready? Take it away. Ha.
Right, we just like to give a big shout out to Denrele here, who's been part of Africa Fashion Week Nigeria and Africa Fashion Week London for years now. He's given us so much support. He's always been there for us, and you know how he is anyway. We don't need to say anything else. But thank you so much for being there for us. He's gonna take on the show now from the second part, which is the gala part, and he's gonna go all the way onto the end of the night. I'm sure he's gonna do a fantastic job as he always has, and I'll leave the rest to you. Thank you so much.
I just must say this, I heard from the grapevine that Barack Obama is your personal assistant, Beyonce cleans your shoes, and I heard that Rihanna is your personal barber. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to know this man. Yes, he doesn't count Naira, he doesn't count dollars, he counts only pounds. And I can put euros too, Abi.
Well, I'm humble as it is, but thank you.
And he gives his son a reason to shine every day.
Thank you. So much.
I have to ask you, because you've worked so hard on this project.
Yeah.
I saw you yesterday at the fashion marathon.
Yeah.
We're here and you don't even look flustered. Rather, you look like you just came out of a spa. How do you manage all that energy? Everyone calling you every minute.
Yeah.
And I mean, you have so much production to handle, presenters to put, the events to run.
I think it's a load of water and at least a minimum of like 8 hours sleep. Now, it's hard to get 8 hours sleep. So sometimes what I do is like split it into 4 hours and then catch some sleep later on during the day. But it's loads of water and just like good energy from people like yourself,
good energy,
positive energy from everyone. That's everyone's welcomed us, everyone's loving, and it's been great. And you feed on that energy, and it's a good vibe, and it's good positivity, even though there's a lot of like fuel scarcity, but people still turn up, people are still here, and that's what's important. And it's a lot of love, and we love everyone for coming, and that's what we love you guys for, man. The best.
Wow. Well, coming from, I call him my Egmonto Shaw, Bobo Big Boys of Life. Well, we like to shorten it as Uncle TK, if you understand what I mean. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I just must add that last year we had like the very first gala night, same venue, but I would say that the gala night hasn't even started.
Absolutely.
And the traffic on the red carpet is amazing.
Yeah.
So many stars, so little time, but we'll get the job done, definitely. Now I have to let you go because everyone is beeping you backstage.
Absolutely.
Where is he? Where is TK? He's going to be there in a bit. But before you run off quickly, now tell us, what sort of show should we expect? Or rather, what sort of extravaganza should we expect to see tonight?
Well, it's going to be a fantastic night. We've got a massive, massive loads of collections. And as you know, Adebayo's ending it with a super huge hit. There's going to be a lot of interesting stuff. We've got drummers, we've got acts, just to give it a little bit of spice. We've got a fantastic opening, which everyone has to see, which represents what's going on today in Nigeria as well as fashion. So we're mixing the trend of fashion with the trend of fuel scarcity. You'll see that when you get in there. But yep, apart from that, it's going to be a fantastic show. Brilliant stuff.
I love that. I mean, despite all the hustle and bustle in Nigeria, you know what? We Nigerians, we know how to make events happen.
Absolutely.
And with the African Fashion Week Nigeria, we're bringing it this year because we're not settling for second place.
Absolutely.
I have to let you go, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for helping my career. And when I grow up, I want to dress like you. I love your outfit. Very practical.
Thank you.
Shorts will definitely get you around.
And
those socks, once I see those socks, I know, okay, yeah, that's him.
But I'll be changing a few times anyway, so I have to.
Watch out for his own special runway. Yes, we're looking out for the clothes off the runway.
Thank you, sir.
Lights, camera, fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most hardworking women on planet fashion. I had to drag her out. I'm sure she's telling me, they're like, hurry, I need to attend to a lot of stuff. I officially would say that Yeti is the most harassed person on this project. I'm not kidding. Her phone rings off the hook. Everyone is constantly asking. I'm sure even some of the models come and meet you. Please, where are my clothes? How on earth is she supposed to know that? Well, Yeti is not only representing PR and A&R for the African Fashion Week Nigeria and AFW London as well, but she has been multitasking on this show. She's been handling production, she's been handling backstage, she's been handling performing artists, the models, the designers, the guests, entertainment, everything. Sweetie, you look like you just came out of a spa. So tell me, have you caught any sleep at all?
Well, we sleep after the hour work.
The work comes first. But I need to ask you, you know, everyone is here tonight. And, you know, last year I was here. But I can say that the gala night hasn't even started. And the traffic here is crazy. Like, you know, are you a little scared that the hall might not contain the people that are coming in today?
Oh, no, I'm sure we can fit them in somewhere. Because we want everybody to experience what we're going to showcase tonight, really. So.
Now tell me, how much time went into planning the 2015 African Fashion Week in Nigeria?
Well, we started over 6 months ago. I think December. We started December because we know it's something we're going to be doing yearly. So we started 6 months ago trying to think about, okay, what concept we're going to do this year. And to see the finished product is fantastic, really. Yes, yes.
I honestly can't wait, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, watch out for Yeti on the runway today. I think she's going to spring a surprise. But I also heard from the grapevine that you've got a collection that you'll be showcasing tonight.
Showcased it already.
Imagine. I was looking forward to it, so I missed it yesterday. I'm sure I definitely saw it. It must have been the early phase, but would we see it resurrect again on the runway tonight?
No. No. If you miss, I'm sure you guys there would watch it anyway.
We'll watch it.
Yeah.
All right, so I know Yeti has to run off because I know you've got to change. You've got so much to handle. But I mean, looking back now, I mean, what sort of impression do you want every Nigerian and African here tonight to live with after the event?
That we have undiscovered talents in Nigeria that needs to be pushed out there. And that's what we're simply going to do tonight, really. And also, we're supporting the Sickle Cell Foundation. It's important to know that it's not just about fashion. We also are backing a charity that is close to our heart as well. Yes.
Fascinating. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is Fashion with a Cause. We're doing everything that we can. So many designers. And I just must add, from 2011 till date, the AFWN and AFWL has showcased over, would I say, 1,000 designers. Count, I'm not kidding. And over 2 million hits on the website. You've also been handling all the graphics, illustrations, social media. Yes, I know. You know, and I have to ask you, before you run off, if we could create a Yeti Day. You know, like we have New Year's Day, we have Christmas, we have, you know, all of that. So we want to create a public holiday for Yeti. I will call it the Yeti Day. What kind of clothes would we wear since we're celebrating fashion here?
I'll be more of the laid-back one. As you can see, I don't like to be fussed up. I like being comfortable. So that would be Yeti Day.
All right. So the Yeti Day, watch out. We're still creating that day, but I have to let Yeti go. Yeti, thank you so much. High five. You rock. Ah, she's a rock. Woo! I see Victoria Michaels in the building. Hey, my Victoria is in the building, rocking as always. Ooh, can I touch her dress and be blessed? Ah, I just got blessed by Victoria. Can I bow down and worship Victoria right now? Are you ready? Woo! Worship again. Woo! Worship again. I hope my hair is not sweeping this floor. It's not. All right, my darling.
I love you.
Love you. Well, I know you want to do an interview quickly and then I'll drag you to mine. Mwah! All right, guys, so now Victoria Michaels is one of the supermodels that we've invited for the AFWN. As you can see, we have all our sponsors here. Everybody. Woo! Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, don't mind me. I like to behave on the red carpet. All right, so in case you're wondering, woohoo! I just ran into one of my very sexy friends. I'm about to drag her. Of course, it's Maria Okorede from the Bait99.9, and she's here tonight, decked out in, woo! African fashion. We'll be back in a bit. Lights, camera, fashion, ladies and gentlemen, it's the AFW 2015. We're live on the red carpet. We're making it happen. Yes, we're bringing it this year because we're not settling for second place. And I've got a very sexy, huh? I call her my bling bling sugar mama. You know, the bling bling one, represented by Rita Nkechi herself, celebrating all the blings. As you can see, let's look at them blings. Woohoo! Woohoo! And then there are more blings there, but I can't touch that area. Well, it's good to have you here. You know, I saw you yesterday. You know, it was crazy backstage. We were at the show. But what sort of extravaganza are you expecting to see tonight?
I think it's going to be electrifying. Totally. Because, you know, coming here yesterday, I saw some amazing upcoming art, designers, and it was so good. Most of them were from Yaba Tech, and I was like, oh, what creativity, you know? So we have a lot of creativity here in Africa, and because I empower women a lot, so yeah.
I got her in the building. Woohoo! Before you run, you have to say something. Just say something quickly.
I love Denrele.
Ladies and gentlemen, I love her so much. She gives the sun a reason to shine every day. And counting, you know, mother of five. Oh. Okay, I know. So you know that it's a red carpet. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. So is there any particular designer you're looking forward to seeing tonight?
Yes, I think yesterday I saw quite a few. I saw Elawi, I think. Yes, I think they were clean cut. You know, their designs were like so cool, and she was consistent with her designs. So I'm looking at seeing her again, and then I'm looking at Elikem. Because I saw a few other things. I was on Twitter yesterday, and I saw a few other things he designed. I was like, wow, I want to see that. And then Meg Alabi, because Meg is a friend of mine, and I want to support her. We used to be models back in the day together. So I'm supporting her today. So and I want to see all the new talents. It's about freshness. Let's see freshness. Let's see something exciting. So that's what I'm all about. So let's see something new.
Okay, so I need to ask you now. Do you think that you look very sexy in like full clothing, minimal clothing, or nothing at all?
I think just being classy. That's it.
See, I should just, you know. And I need to ask you very quickly, what sort of handbag lady are you? Are you like the kitchen sink, carry everything all, or you know, like the little clutch, carry purse, or the very small, cute bag?
I think because I'm a handbag designer myself, so I like to blend. I like to try out new things, and I push fashion. Even though I'm not carrying a handbag now, but I push fashion a lot. So I'm like, I could do a clutch depending on the event, you know. I can be crazy. I like to do a bit of eccentric sometimes. So I could do like a box bag. I could do like a business bag, you know. So it all depends, really. So it all depends.
All right, bling, 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 bling. Good to see you. I want you to keep blinging the night away. Bling away. Mwah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, one of us visiting supermodels is in the building. All hail royalty. A moment of silence, fashion silence, for the one and only, the unstoppable Victoria Michaels. Yeah! Woohoo! Sweetie, you have to take a spin. Woo! Okay, I just must add very quickly that this exquisite, captivating, fascinating, scintillating, enchanting, species, because I don't think you're a human being. I think you're something special, you know. You are definitely going to be opening and closing for Adebayo Jones tonight. We honestly can't wait to see you on the runway. But what was last night like for you?
So far, I've seen very inspiring, you know, very colorful collections. And I'm so proud to be associated with this brand, Africa Fashion Week Nigeria, Africa Fashion Week London. It's a platform that has showcased the talents from Africa. This is what we need to actually project what Africa has got. Yes, yeah, to offer.
You know, and were you at any point very tempted to just jump on that runway and snatch the clothes off the models?
Yes. You know, I just saw Yeti's designs, yeah. And they were breathtaking. You know, after the show, I called and said, Yeti, you know that particular outfit?
The one
that would look very good on Victoria Michaels? Reserve it for me because that's the one I'm taking back to Ghana.
Oh, shit.
And she said, yes, it's yours. Count it done.
You know what? I Victoria, you and I will be on this one. If you need anything, just leave me to go steal it for you. Okay. And I'll get it here. All right, so Victoria is live in Nigeria, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, you know, aside from modeling, aside from fashion, aside from being an ambassador for the AFWN and AFWL franchise, you know, you need to tell us, now that you're in Nigeria, what is it that you like to try your hands on? Because I know you've done a special shoot with Lola Sean, the fashion catalog, the fashion blogger. Shout out to Lola Sean. Mwah! You know, but I need to ask you, what would you like to try your hands out here?
You know, the opportunities in Nigeria are enormous. And being that I am partly Nigerian, I'm looking forward to working with the known brands. In Ghana, I'm the brand ambassador for some known brands, Wooden, Belacqua Mineral Water, Melcom, and now Africa Fashion Week London. So I'm actually looking forward to, you know, be signed on by some of these known brands. But of course, you have to come home. And that is the reason I'm here. Because if they don't see you, how do they get to sign you on? So I look forward to doing great things here. That's what I look forward to. Yeah.
You know, now I'm thinking I wish I had the power. But, I mean, we could make it happen.
I trust
now, we want to create a special holiday for you. You know, like, we have Christmas, we have New Year's Day. We want to create the Victoria Michaels Day. Now, what would we do on that day?
On that day, I am going to feed the hungry. Yes, because there are a lot of kids, homeless kids on the streets who have nothing to eat, and that special day will be their Christmas, and it's something I already started in Ghana and I like to bring it back home. So that's what I love to do on that day.
Signed, sealed and delivered. Oh shit. And then also, now because we're celebrating fashion here, what sort of clothes would we wear on the Victoria Michaels Day? Ha.
Well, because I am African and proudly African, just like you, you can see from my head to toe that I'm African. So I would like us to wear something with an African touch, something that projects Africa, that tells the world, you know, what Africa is and what Africa has got to offer.
And then what sort of music should we listen to? Coming, I mean, it's the Victoria Michaels Day. You have to give us your playlist. What kind of music would we listen to?
Coro de Bello's kind of music. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm his fan.
The Godwin, can you sing? I don't get a lot.
God.
Hey, you say Godwin. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I don't get a lot.
Godwin.
Not only can you mother, but you also sing. This is not fair.
It was designed by B Shape. She's a Nigerian designer. This is Daviva fabric. And what inspired this is because Daviva is a sponsor of Africa Fashion Week Nigeria. So I just thought, why not support a sponsor? And the look was put together by the famous Lola Shaw.
Hey, Lola, you again. I've heard Lola's name tonight. I'm going to send Lola back to her fashion store. All right, guys, we're live on the red carpet. Victoria Michael celebrating with us tonight. Watch out for her on the runway. I have a feeling she's still going to change into like 10 more outfits tonight. She'll beat Eva Longoria's record. Yes, she'll break that record tonight.
Please try. And I love you, Denrele.
Thank you, my darling. Awesome. Mwah. 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 Yay, third one. Mwah. Yay, third one. And Emmanuel Ikubese is here. It's my twilight eyes, ladies and gentlemen. All right, guys. Hey. This is my brother from way back, my people. Yes, and Jorin, have you met him? You know, I keep introducing you to everyone.
How you doing?
Okay, so it's a red carpet. Anything can happen, and we always have to meet people. It's social networking, ladies and gentlemen. So Emmanuel Ikube is a supersonic, most gorgeous man on planet Earth. This
really?
One. Yes. Then now add actor to it. Then there's one hidden talent, singer, lyricist, lyrical messiah, everything. And Jorin, supersonic designer. I think you showcased last year. Yes, and then you're here again tonight too. I know that with you, fashion is starting.
Basibek,
baba. Oyana. Okay, so I am wondering what if Emmanuel is trying to post me on his Instagram or on his Snapchat. But I will just manage it. Are we ready?
Yeah, man, let's go.
Yeah, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, all Emmanuel's children will look like me. Yo!
I'll find it.
Now, you know, like, we have New Year's Day, we have Christmas Day, we have Easter's Day. Yeah. Now, someone whispered to me and said, we have to create an Emmanuel Ikubese Day. What would we do on that day?
On that day?
Yes.
We'll just have kids. Orphan kids. And less privileged kids. And we'll just do like a bash for all of them. Just, somewhere in the center of the city, but like somewhere where they can have, you know, like a Disney World, where all of them can just come and just have fun to the fullest, and they always remember that day. I think that's what I would do on an Emmanuel Ikubese
Day. I'm with you on that one. And then now, because we're celebrating fashion, what sort of clothes would you like us to wear on the Emmanuel Ikubese Day?
You know, those clothes we used to wear when we were kids. You know, like those, where we can just be free. Oh Lord of mercy. Yes. Yeah, those kind of clothes. I'll call it, the dress code should be kiddish, childish. You know, where people can come dressed. Even if it's your shorts and, you know those, you're too much.
You're taking me down memory lane. Now, this is to let you know that Maria and I come a long way.
Yes, we do.
And I farmed her on a regular. I've been begging her to follow me on Twitter, on Instagram, on High Five, on Facebook, on MySpace, on To Go, on Bado. She's not following me on any.
Liar.
You know, I tried to work my mascara tonight. But looking at Maria, she got the upper one and the lower one perfectly.
I love his eyes. It's like, woo!
Twilight mood. Maria, good to see you. I love what you're wearing. Take a spin. Take a lovely spin. Woo-hoo! Now, I need to understand the lower part. Now, it's tied around like a skirt.
Yes.
And then it's got a little bow tie at the back.
Yes.
And then it's like a wrapper again at the same
time. It's a wrapper.
This is the magic of my 15-year-old cousin at home. It was actually a long rapper, but she was like, let's jazz it up a bit. So she kind of twisted it. I don't think she learned this in school. She twisted it around, tied it at the back. I don't know, all this kind of stuff she did. But this is actually by Fabrics by Kiba. Okay. I think she's a new designer, yes. So she dressed me. Thank you.
And then, you know, you're bringing like, you know, you're bringing them 60s, 70s, 80s back with a little crop top. Yeah, that's very shuffly.
It wasn't a crop top. This was actually a longer top. But again, we wanted to jazz it up. So we folded it and then tied it at the back. Yeah, so we just.
I have to meet Maria's 15-year-old cousin. Sweetie, I need help. Either you help me jazz up my hair, and then just jazz up my outfit.
You need any help, Denrele. You know, you don't.
Well, Maria, it's always good to see you. You know, you're rocking tonight. It's African Fashion Week Nigeria, African Fashion Week London. Yeah. And I have a feeling you're running off to change and you're heading back. Or what are you up to? Because you look like you're going this way or you're going that way.
No, I'm going inside. I'm not going to change. I'm going inside, yeah.
Now, do you have any special plans for the night? You know, like, whilst you're dancing, you might just untie the wrapper and we'll have something very sexy underneath.
No. My auntie will kick me out of the house if I do that. I'm actually just going to watch. I want to see all the designers, want to mingle, meet fashion designers, see models. I really love fashion. Like, it's weird because people are like, since when were you into fashion? But when I first moved here, you know, lots of challenges and struggles, so I forgot about my passion for fashion. I forgot about it. Now that everything is a bit better, I'm, you know, much more interested in my passion again. So, yeah.
Are we good to go? Just give me action. Lights, camera, fashion, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, the African Fashion Week 2015 red carpet. It's Eco Hotel and Suite. And of course, I have my biggest egg boy in the building. Ah, you know, tonight it's just about, we're also celebrating not just fashion, but fashion with a cause. And we're giving back to the Sickle Cell Foundation. But I have to do what I was brought up properly to do. So camera, move back a little as I double it for daddy. Are we ready? Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Daddy. Daddy says I should today. Daddy, how are you, sir? The one and only Professor Akinyoju in the building, ladies and gentlemen. He's live on the red carpet for the 2015 African Fashion Week Nigeria. We're going to see him in London definitely as well. But Daddy, how does it feel knowing that your foundation, or rather would I say an initiative that you hold so dearly to your heart is being supported by the African Fashion Week Nigeria tonight?
First of all, how can I get hair like you?
Daddy, don't worry. After this interview, I'll give you hair. Give you
okay,
some.
Okay.
But your cap won't be able to fit too.
No, I know.
We'll make it work.
Fantastic.
Thank you, sir.
No, it's really wonderful that they focused on Sickle Cell Foundation as their charity of choice. It's wonderful because it's a big problem in Nigeria and it will bring awareness to it and more people will help to support it. Because it's got to be sustainable. Although we started it, I'm chairman now, but it's got to be on and on so that we can do work, good work and make more discoveries and make their life easier.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a powerful shot. I've been saying lights, camera, fashion all night long, but this is the moment we've been waiting for. The CEO, the founder herself, just stepped on the red carpet. I wonder who even lets her this way, because she's been working nonstop. Her phones have been ringing. Everyone's been demanding for attention. They've been dragging her backstage. And please, we need to ask her how, underneath all of this madness, she looks like aggression queen. The one and only, the unstoppable, unequaled, unparalleled, and unrivaled, Ronke Ekbogbo Big Skills, Ronke Tosho Ademiliu, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, you're going to do a special introduction for everyone. I have our Maasai queen here. Maasai. And me, I am the Mchawi Mganga, if you know what that means. Aha, she knows. That's some Swahili, small. Auntie Ronkus, do the introduction, please.
Okay, this is Lillian Ajayi, the CEO of Jnisi, one of our sponsors.
Fantastic.
Yes, and this is my friend Ogochukwu, and this is my friend Maureen.
Okay, so we'll start with Ogochukwu very quickly. Ah, Ogochukwu, high five. How many times have you been calling Auntie Ronke's phone that she has even answered you?
10,000 times. Yes. Because she's busy. She's very busy.
How much time has she put into this? You know, because you are a friend, so you can tell.
A lot. She has put everything she has put into it.
As you're here tonight to support your darling friend, how excited are you seeing this happen right now in front of you?
I'm very, very excited. I'm very excited.
One of our friends is trying to run again. You look very gorgeous tonight. And you're one of our proud supporters now, so you can't run away. And you're the African queen for tonight.
Really?
I love your hair.
Thank you. Do you like my sackcloth as well?
I love.
Sack.
Akpo ni.
Akpo. Eton. Ola TV. Akpo ni.
Akpo.
know, budget teller.
I thought it was one of those, you know, like French lace, chiffon, net, share, you know, one of those things. But this is beautiful.
Thank you.
Now, I have to ask you, because I know it takes a lot of guts to wear sackcloth, one. And then again, the temperature will start to run.
Burlap.
You call it what?
Burlap.
Burlap. Burlap. Okay. So we're going burlap tonight. Very quickly, I mean, you're celebrating with us tonight, and that's you're also why. Supporting. Tell us about your brand and how much you are involved in the AFWN.
I've been involved from inception. Ronke is not just a friend, she's a sister as well. We have a nickname. Where is she? Am I allowed to tell everybody what we call ourselves? We call ourselves Friendship. And JNEC Travels is my brand, and JNEC Education, and we're actually one of the official sponsors for African Fashion Week Nigeria. And then we are one of the people that do the New York Film Academy. We have education placement agency, so we represent the New York Film Academy and a few other schools outside, and so many other things.
Yeah, multitasker of life. And you know, I have to also talk to special mommy over here, one of Auntie Ronke's friends. Well, in the boil up, I think you have to do another spin before you go quickly. Yes, yes, yes. Woohoo! Working that dress. Ah. You know, you just might be called onto the runway tonight to take a special catwalk. I'm ready, oh yeah. Contestant number one. Oh shit, sell your market. Woohoo! Auntie, come, before you run. Okay, now, so before you run quickly, now I have to ask you, as you know, one of Auntie Ronke's friends celebrating here tonight, what kind of fashion are you looking forward to seeing tonight?
I would say elegant at its highest peak. Elegant. Yes.
All right. Well, we're looking forward to that. So I have to let you go join your friends and then disturb my Maasai. Thank you. Maasai. How do I greet the Maasai?
You say Jumbo. Just Jumbo.
Oh, Jumbo. Jumbo from the Mchawi Umganga.
I know you don't want to call yourself that because Mchawi means witch.
Witch, yes.
So are you calling yourself a witch?
I am a witch. A red carpet witch.
Oh, really? Fantastic.
Yeah, I say so.
You look so.
Just kidding. Well, you know, all the way from Kenya, we love Nairobi, Kenya. I love it's one of my favorite places in the world. But I had to ask you, celebrating with African fashion now at that, now, how would you say that African fashion has evolved over time?
Well, this being my second year, actually, it's been fantastic. I've seen lots of designers and most of design coming up. So it has something, it's trendy. Yes.
So do we look forward to the African Fashion Week Kenya anytime soon?
Oh, actually, I'll pray to have one. Yes, go. I'll talk to Aunt Ronke and see what she can do with us. We wouldn't mind having African Fashion Week in Kenya. Yes, fantastic. We'd love to have you down.
And then I'm going to look forward to seeing you on the runway tonight. What would your pose on the runway be? What kind of pose would you give them?
Well, I'll give a jump. Maasai.
Maasai, aha! Maasai, yes, that's the Maasai.
Yeah, I'll give a jump.
Okay, all right. Good. Looking forward to seeing you. Love you.
Thank you.
Let me see. Okay, can I just touch you? Whoa, mama. Thank you, darling. All right, yes, I have my two crazy friends here. I have to drag them on here. Yes, yes. You crazy stylist, come here. You madman. And yes.
You talk too much, my darling.
What did you say?
You talk too much.
Sweetie, if I do not talk, I will have no bread on my table. You have to wait. You have to be patient. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of my very good friends here. One of the maddest stylists. He's been working like crazy. You worked all through last night,
yeah.
And now you're here again. Now, you know, Wale and I call you Kojak.
My name is Koje, not Koja. Koje Styling. Thank Koje you very styling. Much.
Yes. And this is my fabulous friend over here. Oh my God, your baby is gorgeous. Like, I want to start having children.
Hello,
how are you doing?
Hi to Derele, mommy's friend.
Darling.
Greg.
That's his way of saying hi. Okay, well, sweetie, because I know I have to let you guys run in quickly. Now, you are here to enjoy the show tonight.
No, we are still walking backstage. We just ran to come at the red carpet and go back.
You look too fabulous to be walking backstage.
That's what I do. I'm a
let's see the back of this dress. Hey! You know, I need to ask you, as a very sexy stylist, mama stylist,
yeah.
Are you going to have your baby with you all through?
I brought my nanny with me, but yes, they are going to be backstage with me.
You are such a diva. Now, I need to ask you, Koje.
Yeah,
yes, I got it right this time now. Now, how many designers have you worked with from the inception of the AFWN till this point?
I worked with, last year, we had like 60 designers. And this year, like I think like 70 designers this year. So it's like a massive show. We had the catwalk, we had the show on Saturday, and we had the pre-gala, and now the gala show, which is crazy, I'm telling you.
Let me feel his temperature. Ah, it's running. You need some sleep. But you don't, you look like you came out of a spa,
it's
I swear.
What I do. It's what I do. Ashade does it well now, you know.
I want to be like you. I want to be like, well, because the two of you are running, have any of the models given you any headaches so far? Because, you know, it's crazy backstage. Yes.
They are very dramatic, honestly. They are very, very, as in like, oh no, I want this this way. No, I want this. I want my children. Oh, they're all there, yeah.
You have to do it that way.
Working with them, it's been fun all the way. It's been crazy, and I look forward to next year and an amazing show next year. Yeah,
well, definitely. Before we look forward to the future, as we always say, the future is not yet here, so let it wait. Tonight is the night that we're ready to go, Gaga. Yeah, yeah. Watch out as Kojak comes on stage and takes off his shirt, and watch out as this beautiful, sexy mama, Shade Aye, Shade to Shio, Shade to Sempe, Shade will come on stage, strike a pose. With Robin.
Robin,
are you coming on stage?
Yes.
Yes. They're already saying yes. So watch out for the two of them on stage tonight. We'll make it happen. Oh, yeah, yeah. Have the very sensual, the sensational, the tantalizingly gorgeous, and of course, not forgetting sexy. But then we also have to put talented and very creative Hadassah. And she's going to be telling us about her label. I know she's showcasing tonight. She's got a lot of tricks up her sleeve.
Yes, I do.
First, I love what you're wearing to start with. And where are you from, by the way?
I'm Nigerian. I'm Yoruba.
Eh?
I am.
Oshekini.
I'm Yoruba.
Oh, Nse Yoruba. Iron you. Answer me, Yoruba. Iron you. Oh, Nse Omo Yoruba.
Omo Yoruba ni mi.
Ah, nipe Iron you, sir.
Omo Yoruba ni mi.
Just kidding. Well, you know, it's good to have you on the red carpet. And of course, we're always here to have a blast, as always.
Eyes, by the way.
Twilight.
They're just
Twilight
fierce.
Mode.
Woo! Fierce, come on.
So let's talk about the collection. What's the theme of the collection for tonight? And, you know, how have you infused it to the AFWN?
Okay, so the theme of my collection is, actually my collection is called Victoria. It's inspired by superheroes. Okay. Growing up, I was a little bit of a comic geek. And also growing up, I've been plus size. So today I'm going to present plus size lady from a very empowering angle, using the theme of superheroes. So basically, Marvel meets AFWN. That's it, really.
You know, and I like anything Victorian, because, you know, it just takes us down those special, you know, those special times when we had to spend a lot of fabric on our clothes. Yeah. Now we have to minimalize it as much as we can. Lights, camera, fashion, ladies and gentlemen. We're live on the red carpet. It's the African Fashion Week in Nigeria. And yes, I know I am sweating up a storm in here, but you know what? It's all for fashion. For fashion, we can drip as much as we want. And yes, we have one of the most amazing designers who's showcasing tonight. She's going to tell us about her collection. She's going to tell us about the theme of the collection. And then, of course, you know this. You know, I know a lot of designers like to reserve the best-selling outfit for last. You know, so you have to tell us what, like, your last 4 or 5 looks are like. But quickly, a quick introduction.
My name is Wendy Tabansi. I'm the president of Barock by Wendy, where we love to do timeless elegance. That's what we're known for. Yeah.
Now, when you say timeless elegance, now we want to see timeless elegance on the runway tonight. Everyone is eager to. Yeah. So give us like a little description of some of the clothes we'll see on the runway.
Okay. What I'm doing is actually, I'm taking elegance and making it a bit edgy. That's what we're doing tonight. So you're going to see elegance that is timeless and yet edgy, because people tend to associate elegance with old school, but we're making it new school and we're making it good.
I'm feeling you on that one, sister. Oh, shit. Ah, Lady Wendy ain't joking this year.
Absolutely not.
Now, you know, also, it's been quite hectic. I know from yesterday, the fashion marathon, the exhibition.
Absolutely.
And then, you know, here. Yeah. And then you look like, you just got out of a spa. You don't even look stressed one bit. But I need to ask you, how much work went into building the collection that we're going to see tonight?
Well, it was a lot of work. I'm not going to kid you about it. Everything you see on the red carpet that is glam is absolutely 100% hard work. You know, it took a lot of designing. But the good thing is, for me, I find designing comes very easily for me, so... But, you know, when you have that also, it comes with a lot of problems, because you get too many ideas and you don't know which one you should be working on. But we were able to streamline everything, chose our colors and all that, and did a lot of night and day work, I can assure you, to get to where we are right now. Because we had a lot of, we also, besides working for the show, we had to work for clients. So, you know,
I wonder how you guys do it. So tonight I can tell that a lot of clients and a lot of customers, or rather a lot of, you know, our guests tonight will definitely see your clothes and buy every piece. So what would happen if you go home with none of the clothes that you showcase tonight?
I'll be singing la 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 la.
And then, you know, there's also one song we have now by Corey DeBello that goes, I don't get a lot. God, the wing. So that alert is what we're looking forward to tonight. Absolutely. From Lady Wendy, look out for her fashion collection tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Before you run off, what's next? What's next for you?
Besides making sure that my eyes look sexier than yours, I'm looking forward to...
I love that.
I'm absolutely looking forward to taking my design collection because I forgot to mention to you that I'm trying to focus this time on something that is more internationally accepted, not just the Ankara bit, you know. So I'm looking for going into the international scene full scale.
Ladies and gentlemen, from a very successful showing yesterday at the African Fashion Week exhibition, Elegante Kids, ladies and gentlemen, if you missed it, you have to call back for a repeat and a rerun. Because right now, the unstoppable, Bobo Bix girls, ever sparkling, timeless, ageless, flawless, and stainless. Tony Lamani is live on the red carpet with me. So first, I have to comment. You know, like, this is like the damask. I can tell this is old age damask. You know, and this is damask that cost a fortune.
I know. It's for my grandma. You know, my grandma, she was the Oba of Ikolekiti. So I saw this was a wrapper, actually. I made it into this in a week. It really took me a long time to do this. But I really wanted to do something different because I'm showcasing today and I'm opening the show, the Irambuba Evolution. Yeah, so they gave Elegante by Tiana Starling the chance to showcase Irambuba Evolution, which I'm doing here, 3,000 as well. You guys need to watch out for that on the runway.
The one and only, the unstoppable Tony on the red carpet. I could go on and then I have to let her go, no doubt, ladies and gentlemen, because she's opening the show. But quickly, before you run off, your involvement in the African Fashion Week Nigeria and African Fashion Week London has been tremendous. I feel like you're already family. Your name should be, you know.
To be honest, I've known Auntie Ronke for like 10 years now. And when she started, we started together. I showcased in London. Then she made me a creative director. Last year. And it was really amazing. This year, I really wanted to have time to put together my own show to show people what I'm all about. You know. She gave me the chance in London and it was a shutdown in London as well. I'm happy it was a shutdown in Lagos as well. And it's going to be a shutdown today as well.
The most fascinating, the most captivating, the one and only, the very hardworking, multitasking, globe-trotting, jet-setting, high-rolling, would I say fire-starting?
Why not?
Hard-rocking. Sinem is in the building, ladies and gentlemen. The one and only, I have been looking for Sinem all my life. You know, Sinem, I think you and I, we became friends on BBM.
Yes.
We used to chat then. And then again, it moved to Twitter and then to Instagram. And then last night, I remember seeing you when you walked in, but it didn't hit me that it was you. I was like, oh, how is this beautiful Oyinbo? And then you sat in front. And then when they tagged us in that picture, I was like, my goodness. I was about to come and start knocking on all the doors in Lagos, looking for you. Sinem, come out. But it's good to see you, my darling. And you look amazing.
Thank you.
How now?
I'm good. It's fun.
You know, I know you're like family with the AFWN and AFWL. You know, Auntie Ronke Ademilui is a very good friend of yours as well. So how does it feel from last night and then now, you know, as compared to last year and the other seasons in London?
Well, this is the first time I'm at the Nigeria one at AFWN, and it's been fantastic. And obviously tonight is the culmination, the gala night at the Bio Jones this year, all the way from London. So I'm really looking forward to that. And last night as well, there were some great talents on the runway. So yeah, like, it's amazing. And I am glad that they carried the London success to Nigeria back home.
Were you tempted at any point in time last night to jump on the runway and rip the clothes off the models? Like, I want this outfit.
Yes. I think there was a House of Obona. I'm not sure if I've got the name right. And some of the clothes were delectable. And I was like, give me that. And Souza Fashion, I already tagged her on Instagram. And I said, I need this outfit in my life. And she's like, I got you, babe. So, yeah.
Sinem's been working.
You're a super, super, super gorgeous lady. Congratulations for today. I'm so proud of you. Well done. The sky is the limit for you, Aderonke. Mwah.
Mwah! And I have to let my two. Hey! Oh, we're doing Amebo. Amebo,
yes,
Amebo.
I'm holding you.
Why are you holding me?
You're not going to go away.
Ah.
Because you're most wanted. Everybody wants to get Denrele for the night. So I'm holding.
That sounded very.
Okay, no problem.
Don't worry, I am your takeaway for the night. Take
no
me away.
No.
Take me with you.
I heard that you're taking now. So
I'm not taking yet. So.
I heard you.
No ring on my finger.
There's a truth in every rumor. There's a truth in every rumor. Yeah.
You understand?
I do.
Well, it's good to have my darling here. You know, the moment I saw you, like, whilst I was conducting my interviews, I just saw you over my camera. I saw the hairdo. You know, very, very Grace Jones-esque.
I know.
You know. But it's good to have you here, sweetie. So quickly, tonight is all about fashion. We're celebrating fashion at its height, African fashion. And that is African Fashion Week Nigeria. Hey! Oh yeah, now this is the second edition in Nigeria. And then, of course, this is like the fifth edition, which will be happening in London next month. So what sort of clothes are you expecting to see on the runway tonight?
Very eccentric looking, you know, because I love style and I love to be unique. So I'm looking for that uniqueness and eccentricity today.
I live for eccentricity. Edgy eccentricity.
Yes, team awesome hair. Woohoo! Team awesome hair. Hashtag team awesome hair. Dude, don't like.
Okay, let's not scatter. Sorry.
You know,
oh yeah, don't scatter. All right then. So I mean, whilst we've been on the red carpet, I mean, you know how it is. Events like this just bring you closer to people you haven't seen in a very long time. So is there anyone you saw today that you're like, oh, you? Where have you been? I've been looking everywhere for you.
Yes, actually, yeah. Some friends from school.
Okay.
I finished from Unilag. Yeah, Unilag. Pause for effect.
Me too. Now, great as a cockite.
Great. So, and we've all turned out to be doing great things, and I'm not surprised to be seeing them here. And I haven't seen them in a long time, so it was really nice seeing them here today.
Awesome. All awesomeness. She is awesomeness and gorgeousness put together. Well, sweetie, before you run up very quickly, now tell me, if you were like James Bond for one day, an undercover agent, you know, agent 001, who would you like to follow around and spy on for just one day?
Okay. Beginning home to Nigeria, it will be Lynx.
Utunu.
I love that guy.
Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, he needs no introduction. Every time I see him, I have to stalk him. Like, I practically have to cross 7 mountains, jump over 7 seas. And, you know, I mean, Adebakare is always busy. He's a multitasker. And, of course, Uncle Manager is always here, as always, looking very dapper. You know, you're so lucky. Because, I mean, if you're getting married or you have to go for every occasion, Adebakare to the rescue. And I'm getting married soon. I haven't decided if I'm wearing a dress or a suit. But whichever it is, I will...
We'll design it for you.
We'll design it. We'll design yes. It. So, I mean, African Fashion Week Nigeria, African Fashion Week London. You guys, you have your fingerprints on both franchises, no doubt, you know. And Ronke is a very good friend of yours. Yes. And I know tonight we have some magic that we're going to be seeing from you. So give us a scoop.
Well, actually, it's always a pleasure to be invited for the Africa Fashion Week because we participated last year, both in Nigeria and England. And but this year, we're not showing in Lagos, but we're going to hopefully show in England. But we're looking forward to the show as guests. You know, it's always nice to come to support Ronke because I think what she's doing for African Fashion Week is very impressive. You know, she's really getting, a new team of designers that emerge all the time, giving them limelight and giving them the support. And I think it's needed. And I like the fact that it's regular, you know, every year in May, you look forward to it, and then August in England. It's amazing.
Exciting. And of course, to my bros over here, yes. You know, every time I see, I just know you're always ready to have a good time. You know, and you know how to party for Africa. So tonight, would you be sitting or you'll be on that table rocking away?
Oh, of course, rocking away. You know, yes, and also see how things, of course, it's just a glamorous event that people like. You like to see what people are wearing, what is in vogue, and all that, and also try to now see what's next for Africa after that. What's next for Africa? So keep looking for looking out for something new, creative, and fabulous. That's why we're here.
Very well said. Now, I need to ask you, Uncle Ade, you know, have there been times where you sit back, you're watching a collection, and you're like, this person has been stealing from me? You know, like you see, like, duplicates of your collection. Has it happened to you? And what do you do? How do you handle it? Do you jump back and say, you designer, come here, you've been stealing from me?
No, I think being in fashion for almost 2 decades, I like to believe that I inspire others. So I'm always flattered if people, you know, have taken sort of my signature, that sort of thing. I just feel inspired. And they always say great minds think alike. And it makes me, you know, validates me that at least I'm current.
Like that. Ha! It must say you just answered my question. Sha! You know, but before you guys go off quickly, I mean, if we had the power to create, you know, like we have public holidays, we have like New Year's Day, we have Christmas Day, and we now want to have the Adebakare Day. What would we wear on the Adebakare Day? And what kind of food would we eat on the Adebakare Day? You decide. What would we even do on that day?
I think it has to be very glamorous. I'm known to do very glamour things. You know, people say always elegant, always Adebakare. I think that's our motto. So I think maybe black tie, black and white, and then it would be very sort of international cuisine, you know, a bit of African, a bit of Western, a bit of, you know,
and what kind
everything.
Of music would we listen to on that thing?
Jazz. I love jazz. I love jazz.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lights, Camera, Fashion, I bring to you the most translucent and most luminous diva on my red carpet tonight. She says she's sweating, but I say she's glowing. She's ageless, timeless, flawless, and stainless. The one and only breast from Ghana. She showcased at the pre-gala tonight, ladies and gentlemen. But look at that outfit. Ah, it's a knockout. Sweetie, I will gladly be your chief bridesmaid. Are you married?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so in case you want to have like a wedding anniversary and you have to wear a long dress, please call me. Because I helped you arrange your dress well today.
Yeah. I will call you at any time, darling.
So let's talk about the collection today. What was the theme of the collection? Well, and how do you think the reception was?
Okay, well, I will say, first of all, Nigeria is one of the biggest. I was so intrigued by the reception given me on stage. Second of all, this is my second major show. I will say it's a plus. I haven't seen something like this before. I am so happy, excited for my brand. Yeah.
Oh, Bresta, we love you. And, you know, Nigerians love you already. Now, already as the Nigerians receive your outfits, do you plan on setting up here in Nigeria?
Yeah, I've got two shops, actually, wanting to stock my shop. We have a meeting tomorrow, so I will go and see them and then see what they have in store for me. But I am ever ready to stock in Nigeria. Nigeria is my second home. Ghana, Nigeria, baby.
Oh, shit. Now, you need a Nigerian name. Have you gotten any yet?
Mind, darling, give me one.
Before the end of this interview, I definitely have to give you one. And well, tonight is the gala night. The opening sequence is on right now. What sort of extravaganza are you hoping to enjoy tonight?
Well, this is fashion. I am hoping to see high fashion, high extreme fashion, African fashion. That is it. Yeah.
Beautiful and very well said, ladies and gentlemen. We love Bresta. Bethel rocks. She's my red carpet queen for tonight. And her Nigerian name is Ronke. Ladies and gentlemen, our rising superstar, rising icon from Music Meets Runway, which was like a couple of months back, I would say late last year, is here on the red carpet with me celebrating at the African Fashion Week Naija. And she's also going to London too. Supersonic diva. Sweetheart, where is all the money that you won?
I don't know. Small.
And then the school that you are going to, the School of Fashion, I have to join you.
Yes, yeah, so I need you there, beg. Your sense of style is crazy. It's crazy.
I love what you're wearing to start with. This is very... You know, it's very, it's one of those clothes where you think you are seeing everything, but you're not seeing. Others go wear for stage, go crazy. So just bring out your checkbooks. For those of you that hide your money in your bra, I will put my hand inside that bra and bring out that money. Eh? We need it, Abby.
We need it.
I love it. Camera Fashion, ladies and gentlemen. It's the African Fashion Week, Nigeria 2015, and we're ready inside, finally. Like, you know, I was standing on the red carpet and I was saying to myself, when will I ever get inside? And I thought I was going to be bounced, but my Twilight mode eyes scared the living daylights out of everyone who tried to stop me. Sweetie, what kind of fashion extravaganza are you expecting to see tonight?
Oh, I'm going to see something different from the usual, you know, fashion.
You know, we're celebrating African fashion at that. Would you at any point in time be tempted to jump on the runway and rip the clothes off the models and run away with them?
Oh my God, I love the British show I'm seeing right here. I wish I could have one, honestly. I'm going in immediately.
All right then. Well, I'll ask you to quickly run in, get your seat, enjoy the show, and I'm going to come and sit next to you. And then if we can put our foot on the runway and have the models fall.
Thank you so much.
Yes. Yeah, take care, love. All right, and yes, my very wonderful friend. I like to call him Americana Returnee. The one and only, the unstoppable. Body for days. Are you talking to me? Give me my Balmain dress, sweetie. Mwah. Okay, you know we can always look. It's a red carpet. Now
right,
we can.
Right,
anyone
right.
else we should be scoping right now.
Right.
Someone's got my kind of hair. What's that? Okay, well, you know, I need to ask you, Inc. I mean, you just got into Nigeria after a very long time.
Yeah.
You know, and when I saw your Instagram, I was like, this yellow man is coming to Nigeria. You know, any worries about you getting dark anytime soon? Because the sun is very merciless
right.
in this part of Africa. And then, of course, now there's no fuel. It's quite crazy, but you will survive, won't you?
Yes, of course I will survive. And of course, the key is sunscreen. That's the key.
Uh-huh.
Very much. SPF 60, that's what I use. Woo-hoo. So I think I'm ready for the Nigerian sun, yeah?
Oh,
but of course, we all need a tan. I miss this country. It's been 11 years. And I can't believe I stayed 11 years without coming back. But I'm excited that I'm back. I feel, you know, the love and I feel the energy. So I'm excited to be here.
If we could have a Yinka George Day, you know, like a public holiday, just like you have, like, you know, New Year's Day, Christmas Day, yeah. What would you do on that day? What would we do? And what kind of clothes would we wear? We'll go half naked, I'm sure.
Well, there's that too. But, you know, there is, of course, you know, wearing the best pieces. Just be you and just wear the best piece that you can wear. Whatever it is, that your favorite underwear, your favorite clothing, your favorite hair, just wear it and just be loud and just be you.
Oh, are we ready? Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Antimo, you haven't looked at my eyes yet.
Oh my God.
Are they scaring you? Twilight mode. Okay. Antimo is here, ladies and gentlemen, one of our amazing sponsors. Ebony Life has been all over the place. I practically feel like I'm hosting for Ebony Life right now.
Right.
Yes, mommy is looking at me. Mommy is wondering, what is wrong with this boy? Mommy, you can't go. Mommy, if I came to your house and I told you I wanted to marry your daughter and pay the bride price, what would you say?
Auntie, like, what would you say?
Mommy, don't lie. You.
They dress somewhere else.
I love that. Mommy, before you run, our wonderful senator is here, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, Lady Moabodu. Lady Senator Florence Itagiwa in the building. Well, African Fashion Week is the height of African fashion. I mean, and also we're celebrating fashion with a cause. We're giving back to the Sickle Cell Foundation as well. How do you feel representing with... Ah, since Yaoge is also here as well. Lady Biola Okoya. Mommy, all your people are here now. It's like a family reunion, high school reunion, more like. What would you like to say to all the faces you haven't seen in a while?
Enjoy the evening. You understand? We support African outfits. I'm wearing one. I'm a great fan of African outfits, you know, because our designers are amazing. They're getting better by the day. And, you know, I'm looking forward to a wonderful evening. That's why I'm here.
Okay. And mommy, enjoy the evening. And who knows, you just might come on the runway as the hottest model of the night. I hope you're ready.
Why not?
She's already giving us the pose. Lady Mo, and now you are wearing killer heels, because from standing from that angle, I saw those shoes and I was like, only one woman can pull this look off.
Should I give them to you when I'm done with them? Really? What do you think? I'm sure we're around the same size.
Around the same. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's Moa Abudu. Of course, you know how she's ageless, timeless, flawless, and stainless. Mm-hmm. Only you now.
Always makes me feel good. Always makes me feel good.
It.
Hey.
You work hard for
it.
Well, Ebony Life partnering with AFWN and AFWL. I mean, what's the future? Like, the moment you got the proposal, what made you say, I'm jumping on board?
It's always about showcasing the best of Africa. Okay. It's showcasing the youth. It's showcasing particularly those that are sort of trying to sort of make a name for themselves. Of course, there are other established shows in Nigeria today, but everybody has a journey that begins from somewhere. And the designers we're seeing today are new and upcoming designers. And as you know, if you look at Ebony Life Television, most of the talent you see on our channel have never been anywhere but Ebony Life TV. But as you know, everybody now, they've become stars, you know?
They're everywhere now.
They're everywhere now. So for us, it's always about identifying the new, you know, looking for those rough stones and making them into diamonds. And that's exactly why we are supporting this project and this event. And Ronke is my aburo, so I'm here to support her.
This is family. Yeah. Of course, with Moabudu, she puts a full stop at the top spot. Babe, bam, timeless elegance. Sweetie, now I need to ask you, how are you going to sit in this outfit? It's not a dress, in this outfit.
Gracefully like this.
I love that. And of course, Lola Sean is here. Lola Sean, the amazing fashion editor, fashion blogger, everything fashion. Lola is right at the top. Lola, I mean, we're here tonight. What sort of night should we expect? And then how do you hope to enjoy yourself tonight?
Really, you know, we always have a way of finding that thing that makes us happy. But tonight I'm looking forward to Victoria Michael walk the runway. I need to see her close the gala, and I just can't wait to see her in those Adebayo Jones outfit. Tonight is going to be bloody. It's going to be nice. It's going to be hot. Really, with you here now, you know.
We'll make it happen. I love that. Give me my own too. Give me my own. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, Victoria Michaels is going to be strutting tonight in Adebayo Jones. Timeless elegance as always. Lola Sean is going to be rocking. We have to all sit together somehow and cause some commotion up in here. Are you ready, ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I'm here. You know I'm here, fashion police. Yeah, yeah. I'm here to see what is right, what is wrong, who wore it right, who wore it...
Well,
you know.
Who was a fashion guru, who was a fashion victim, who's class, who's trash. Leave that to Lola. Victoria Michaels, I'm going to let you run now. We love this outfit. Okay, someone take a picture. Hey, they're helping my career. And whoa! Yes, draw the curtains and step back inside. And it's time to enjoy the show. But you know what? I have the very sensual, the very glittery. I have to use the word glittery, yeah. She's glittering tonight, you know. And you know, I saw her in a previous number and then in another glittering number. And yesterday she was in leather. She looked very edgy in that ponytail. Shade Ladikwa, where are thou? Take this microphone and do it just... See, she's right beside myself. Was she... Is this the Arambe dance? Oh, yeah. All right, I have to let my fabulous Shade run right now. Shade, the mic is all yours. Go in, work. And if you need help, sweetie, you know, I am right on hand.
All right, so I'm sitting down here with one of the pioneers of fashion in Nigeria. You don't know this man, but I have watched you for a while. You are an Amazon of a woman. Yes, you are. And a lot of young people need to learn a lot from how graceful you are, how beautiful you are, and how you have carried yourself. I mean, it's an inspiration for you to be part of the show. How does it feel to be part of the second, you know, African Fashion Week in Nigeria? How does it feel?
Oh, it's something we are all looking forward to. It's been a fantastic show. Last year I was here and I did have this fashion show, you know, and I'm here again this year to watch the show.
So,
and it's very, 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 very encouraging.
Is there any particular fashion designer that you think, you know, is fantastic for this generation, maybe that you know personally?
Well, I know so many of the designers, and but with this show now, I'm just coming. I'm just watching, so I can't decide yet, but they're all gorgeous, they're all beautiful.
So far, have you seen any that you say, you know what, I want that for me?
Oh, I've seen so many that I want, so many. And I'm going to patronize them, I'm going to speak to them later on, and I'll order some of them.
All right, so we're here with Chief Opral Benson. I got that correct.
Yes, that's my name, Chief.
Chief Opral Benson.
The Iyaoge of Lagos.
Yes, the Iyaoge of Lagos. And you look exactly like your title. You look beautiful, ma. You look very regal with the head tie. And
I got that title in 1973, so that's a long time ago. Now it's for you young people.
It's for all of us. Fashion is timeless, just like you.
Well, fashion goes and comes, it changes on and off. And I think through Nigeria, it has done a good job of continuing to progress as time goes on. And I think there's one thing that makes us happy, those of us who have got involved with the industry.
How does it feel seeing young people doing fashion now? And you are still able to relate to them, because I can see what you're wearing. This is what we wear. We wear the same kind of material. Oh. It's true.
No, yours is much better than what I'm wearing now. I'm wearing, since this show is for fashion over the years, I'm wearing some of the old dresses that I had. So yours is nice and new and fresh.
It doesn't look old.
It's old.
No, but, you know, how does it feel seeing all these young designers and their showcase? How does it feel? What's the difference between then and now?
I think the object really is to feel good about what you are doing and to appreciate the industry. And I think even now more persons have gotten involved than what there was in the past, because everybody have come to realize among the young people that this is something which you really should be proud of. And people have gone into a full swing. So the difference I think now is that now you have more support than you did in the past, because many more people are interested. That's what I think, yes. And many more young people are involved, and I think that's a good thing.
Well, we are proud in the fashion industry to have you as our Iyaoge.
He's
a photographer. Sorry, he didn't know.
You hit my head.
So we are proud in the fashion industry to have you as our Iyaoge, because we look at you and you are still as fashionable as ever.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm very pleased to be part of you. And I know that you have gone out of your way to look for the older people that used to be part of it. You know?
You are still part of it.
Thank you very much.
So we are here with Mr. Taufik Okoya. Say hello.
Hello.
And one of my, that's Miss Adaku.
You know,
one of my I'll call you my mentor, because you don't know, I know you don't know you're my mentor, but I'm in the industry, in the entertainment industry. I'm also a businesswoman, and I look at you, I'm like, okay, I could be her.
Thank you.
Now, how does it feel to be part of the African Fashion Week? I mean, you I'm sure you've seen fashion grow, because you are a fashionista.
Well, sometimes I get it right and sometimes I get it totally wrong, and I'm like, why am I wearing that outfit? Because sometimes I find that I just focus so much on work that when it comes to time to go out, literally
I'm in my wardrobe thinking, what am I going to wear today? I wish I sometimes had more time to plan what I'm going to wear. So, and I hate shopping. So when I shop, I just kind of like just shop at the same time.
A woman who doesn't like to shop?
I don't like shopping. I just find it an absolute nuisance, just going out and trying on clothes. I just wish there was an easier way to just get my wardrobe, have all the most amazing collections without having to try them all on. I do not like shopping at all. I don't mind shopping for shoes, but because they're easy to put on. But for clothes, I don't enjoy it.
Okay, so far, Taufik, have you seen anything on a showcase that you think, you know, potential?
First off, let me quickly go back to what my beautiful sister has said here. For a woman that has looked as beautiful as she does every other time, I find it hard to believe that she doesn't pay attention to shopping. You know, she rarely ever misses, you know? I'm like, she's a style icon. She's a strong personality, yes. But then again, I think that comes across in her style. And I see that, she might not see it.
She might not pay
attention to it, but it's there. So yeah, we can downplay that, but it's okay.
How far do you think the fashion industry has come so far? I mean, these kind of platforms are great, but how far does it affect the industry really?
It's affected it quite a great deal because people now don't wear what we call imported clothes, you know, and designer names like that. We have them wearing it, but most importantly, they pay attention to our local tailors that cause, you know, they're also designers, and the quality designs that they come up with beautiful colors. And we have lovely fabrics. You know, so they play around with that, and we're beginning to appreciate them. So this, I think, is just the beginning of better things to come, to be expected in the fashion world.
Okay, let me allow you to go back to the rest of the show.
Thank you very much.
One more and then we're done.
I'll give you a little instance. Today I saw Beyonce in an Ankara wrap skirt. Enough said. Beyonce is trending with Ankara. Rihanna has tried it as well. There are Nigerian African designers out there, stylists who are very fashion forward, pushing our name, you know, pushing the envelope. So yeah, we must be doing something right, you know, and not just about doing something right. We must actually have owned our own, whatever it is, you know. So It's good to come out here and show support, and also look out for new talent, look out for what's hot, what's unusual, you know. For me as a creative, it just gives me latitude to think.
I'm here with Yemi Alade, and we're at the African Fashion Week Nigeria, and you are a fashion icon, whether you like it or not. What you've been doing with your hairstyles has made you very unique. And it's also made people decide to trend it, you know? How does it feel to be able to say, you know what, I created that trend?
Man, like, it's like an infectious hairstyle. I don't even understand. And people keep tweaking it and keep understanding it. People from different parts of the world, Tanzania, even when I was on my Euro tour, I had Italians weave their hair up just to show that, okay, we know you and we love you. So the feeling is genuine, it's warm, and I'm really excited. I'm thankful to God and to Clarence Peters and my hairstylist for, you know, starting everything in the beginning, you know, and for life. I'm thankful. I'm very thankful.
So what's your take on fashion? As in, if you had your way, would you dress up, or you're a jeans and t-shirt kind of girl? What's your fashion style?
You know, they say that in life we should keep everything to moderacy, but be very moderate in everything you do. Unfortunately, I don't have that skill. I'm either drop dead symbol or drop dead dress up. And so I don't think I'll at any time either be that girl wearing jeans and a tank top or all over your face Lady Gaga and stuff. So I can't really say, I'm two-sided.